Hello, and welcome to another devlog of the game Secret Life of Dorian Pink, a narrative-based RPG where you have to save your boyfriend from the devil, on the way meet people and creatures and rethink life's priorities. Okay, so a few weeks ago I worked on a shit ton of visuals for the level design. The glow, the trees, the street lamp's glow from the light, these are all on different layers, as many of you might already know, so I can animate them separately in Godot. I have also gotten to that point where I want to, and have to, start thinking about music and audio. An instructor suggested during my thesis presentation, WC indulgent music in the background, which thematically connects to the hedonistic topics in the original Dorian Gray book. So like, instead of rushing to save his boyfriend Basil, Dorian is sort of walking around and stuff and taking his sweet time. I also didn't want to implement a timer mechanic. I personally don't like feeling pressured when playing games. I love a lot of chill games that are narrative based, sort of like
Dream Daddy.
But high stakes and challenges are fun too. A good example I'm sure everyone knows about is Celeste, the platform with a good story, good stakes, and good silent moments in between. When you die, you quickly respawn in the same scene, so that took off some of the pressure. I would be crippled in sweat and self-hatred and terror and frustration and stuff if I played a roguelike. Honestly, considering getting Hades though. Anyway, back to the music. I had three options. I could license this collection of Debussy music from this one website I found that has really good music that fits right into the story. Musicians take a long time to master their craft and find their style. I respect that. But normally, I let an idea simmer for a few days and a few weeks. Later, I came to my senses. I literally am not in a financial position to do that. And for my first game, at that. So moving on to the second choice, I worked with a really talented game composer in a game jam once. I was thinking I could either collaborate with her or pay her. I don't like undervaluing art, so it was either I could pay her a good price or I don't pay her at all. And as for collaboration, well, I don't know. I never really had a good history with collaboration, especially non-money related collaborations. With collaborations, how do I put this? If you fall out of love with a project, there's no money incentive to make you want to roll out of bed in the morning, and it's just stressful. Third choice, well, spoiler alert, I went with this one, which is to make my own music. Terrible idea! I spent days brushing up on music theory and realized how badly my past piano teachers taught students. No wonder I changed teachers 6 times. No kidding, and still ended up giving up on piano anyway, and my brain is probably bigger now, so I got this really small MIDI keyboard and downloaded a trial of FL Studio, which is the software that Toby Fox and Eric Barone used for their games. And we'll see how it goes. Maybe I can share some stuff in the next few devlogs. Oh yeah, I've also been working on some character sprites, more expressions, and the story. I finally got off my procrastination of continuing some dialogue. Yes, honestly, I have no idea how long the time duration will be for the game, because I'd feel pretty shitty for having spent 1 year on making an, I don't know, 45-minute game. But I think we'll be fine. I hope we'll be fine. And finally, let's get to the juiciest part of these past few weeks. Juicy and dripping with stress! If you follow my previous devlogs, you might know that I'm using Dialogic for the dialogue system. Well, that has been working really well for prototyping my demo, which doesn't have that many branching narrative and choices going on. And for your info, at this moment, Dialogic version 1.2 has launched. There is a tremendously helpful feature of grouping your timelines, which are files that contain the story, into folders. So that is tremendously helpful. And as a proud member of Emilio's Discord group, I have been sharing some progress on my game there. And Emilio implemented a new little feature in Dialogic for my game to make it more convenient to add portraits. It used to be that whenever you introduce a new character, you have to put in a join character event, and then if you want to introduce another character, you have to make the first character leave. It's great for visual novels where there are a few characters on screen and different positions because you can dim one of the characters when the other one is talking. But for my dialogue style, there's only one character on the dialogue box at all times. So you can imagine it's a nightmare to manage these timelines. So Emilio made this little checkbox that lets you set single portrait mode, so you don't have to manually make characters leave every single time. Okay, here's the stressful part. As I put in more dialogue into Dialogic, I realized that it gets really difficult to manage branches. I manually copy and paste from Twine into Dialogic, and when I need to edit something, I need to scroll past long lists of UI and words. And I love Dialogic, but my game being so text-heavy, I realized that in order to preserve my sanity, perhaps I need to make my own dialog system and try not to lose my sanity in the process of making that. So I made a JSON dialog system. I still don't know how I did it. It was just a mixture of guessing and looking at documentation and just like stressing. I don't know if making my first minigame or making a dialog system from scratch felt more difficult. It's much easier than pasting text into Dialogic one by one with this dialog system that I've created, because now I'm using Google Sheets to store my dialog, and I can use an add-on or like a plugin-like thing to save this sheets as a JSON file to parse later in Godot. Like, look at me just like throwing out all these words. Like, I don't even know for sure what parse is. I just have an idea of what it is. Like, ooh, yeah, I don't know. Oh my gosh. Like, when am I able to call myself a game dev? I don't know. Also, I just wanted to point out that I'm using Atom for my text editor for the JSON files. It has always been my go-to text editor. Really simple and has all the features I need. And I tweak the file there. And I drop it into my dialog system, and bam! Dialog! But the thing is, my code looks so convoluted and bloated. Like, is this normal? I have no idea. Because there's not a lot of resources online, and I have gone through a lot of them, and there's a lot of basic resources on how to make JSON dialog systems, or even other ways to make dialog systems that don't have to do with JSON. But it's, like, because dialog systems are so personal, or, like, it's, you have to look at what kind of features you need. So I get why people don't put tutorials online, and also if you get to the point of making a dialog system, you probably have the ability to search and put things together in your brain and sort of figure it out. But this is why I have no idea what the best way to make it is, and right now my dialogue manager code is so bloated. I don't know if this is normal. I have features like wait times, pause words, word animation and sound, effect, emitting signals, calling functions. And I know there's not exactly a right way to code, but I just feel like I've coded a major bug into the dialogue system and I don't know yet. And it's going to come bite me in the ass later for undesirable coding practices and dependencies. Every time I run the game stops. And an error shows, my heart does a mini dive. It's so battered and bruised now, my heart. It's like, I don't expect the dialog to work without first failing 20 times. I also think I might want to start making some tutorials soon. If you're watching this, let me know what you would like me to cover in regards to making games that will help you. And I guess I'll try my best to help with my limited knowledge of coding, or just like art or other things in general and related to game development. Or like, if you have nothing you want me to cover, well, that's fine, good for me, I guess. I'll continue just posting whatever I want. Oh damn, I almost forgot. I managed to figure out how to save games. Again, not sure if the way I figured out is the best way or even a good way, but it works for now. Maybe I can talk more about it in the next video or like a tutorial if anyone thinks it will be helpful. And thanks for watching as usual. Do the usual, like, subscribe, and just comment thoughts or something to help the algorithm. Thank you. And join Dorian Pink Discord if you like. Let's chat and see you in the next video.